I couldn't find a compact case for the Raspberry Pi Zero to complement its thinness, so I made my own. The thinnest case I could find was still many times thicker than the Zero, so what I used was I found heat shrink tubing. I used a 1-inch heat shrink tube and just wrapped it around and used a hair dryer. Used a hair dryer, set it to a high heat and low wind, and just shrunk it. And then I cut the holes to let out the power, OTG, and the HDMI cable to come out. And I cut a little bit of a crescent here for the SD card to come out. And I can't imagine a thinner case than this. The tube itself, before it shrinks, is about 1.5 inches. Once you shrink it, it shrinks below 1 inch. I used a little box cutter to cut little slits here, and I used scissors to go around it. Since the edges are sharp, the edge of the connectors are sharp, I was able to use a box cutter to go along, outline the edge here, and get a shape, thin it out, and then cut it with the scissors. And since it is this is tubing for electrical wires, so it's electrically isolated, so you don't have to worry about shorts or placing it on metal objects, except that this shield might be grounded, so it might be electrically grounded also, so it might be the same negative electrically connected, the negative to the, and it might be possible to short also. The tube blocks heat a little bit, but I've tested it and it tested okay. I did some updates, apt-get updates, played some videos, ran an Apache web server on it, and it only loaded enough to load the CPU to 100%, and the temperature was maximum at about 40 centigrade or 104 Fahrenheit, so warm to the touch, but not very hot, even at 100% CPU. And since it is only tubing, plastic tubing, it could be a little fragile. This will fit in your pocket. It'll go in pocket alright. But just don't get too rough with it. Although the Zero is pretty rugged, and it's shipped in a plastic piece of thin plastic anti-static bag anyway, so it's shipped all stacked together, pounds and pounds of weight, all crushed together, and it's not damaged, so I think it's pretty rugged anyway. Don't worry about it too much, just don't get too rough with it. Alright, camera can still be plugged in here, SD card is still removable, and flying on the bottom. And I use a hairdryer, but you should use a heat gun, which I also have a heat gun, I just couldn't find it, but I do have a heat gun, which would be more appropriate because it blows out low wind and high temperatures. You can also use a lighter, but it'll blacken it a little bit. As you can see, it blackens it just a little bit. And it produces very little heat, but you could probably slip it into your glove and use it as a hand warmer, perhaps. Anyway, you come up with your own ideas. The CPU is right here. And you could also cut a hole for the CPU. I didn't do that because I didn't see it being necessary because it was not even warm. So, it seems to work out for me, and Hope it worked out for you. Thanks for watching.